Hi friends of Cut Africa, welcome back to this channel. So this video is about this hairstyle, how to...
So it's now about 2 weeks with this hairstyle. Great for office, outdoor activities, casual parties, the warmer months. You don't want anything that would make you sweat. So this is a great relief. Short, light.
So this would call Afro tapered bob that features shorter hair at the back as it gradually gets longer, thicker towards the front. Usually on straight hair, this is referred to as inverted bob. How long or short the bob will be usually depends on the length of your hair, your preference, or even your face shape. You generally have more flexibility when your hair is longer.
Okay, now using the arc of my eyebrows, that's how I make the front and up to about the middle of the crown. So you could choose to cornrow, crochet the braids. But for me, specifically the front, I twisted using these braids, passion twist. Unravel, cut them into smaller pieces according to the length that I was going for. So you grab a small section of hair and start braiding from the root so as to have a firm base, making your hair as the third leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. I divide my natural hair into two and combine them with the extension hair on both sides. Twist up to where my natural hair stops and then twirl the rest. One thing that I love about passion twist is when you twist it this way, it does not look like twists, it looks like natural curly hair, especially after some few days. I'm going to just do lines at the back and then crochet. So I'm going to leave a link of a video that demonstrates how I do cornrows for crochet, especially at the back and also at the front, of course. So please check link in the description box. Insert the pin under the braid, open the clutch, fix the extension hair, close the clutch, pull the hair, and then make a knot. I make two so it's more secure.
So this is what we have now. I'm going to cut and then check through and see if I need to add, make the necessary adjustments according to what it looks like. So I've also changed the outer hair. This just helps the hair slide off, the hair that will be falling off. So first thing, I want to get this on top.
First, let's assess the angle that we want to take in the hair. How do we want to build the weight? Where should it start from? By looking at this hair, as short as it is, I can already tell where the angle is going to stop. I can't have the length longer than this. It's also easier for me to start from the side so that I can see what I'm doing at the back.
Well, take note, we have three sections here. The bottom, then the parietal ridge to mid-crown, and then the front.
Now, behind my ears, my best guide is the occipital bone, just right across the occipital bone. So I hold my scissor vertically following the head shape, and then my guide along the parietal area towards mid-crown. Do we want it heavier at this point or?
When I reach here, I spread the hair the way I want it to look, and then I blend it with the rest, cut it in such a way that it corresponds with the rest of the hair to give that tapered bob.
So just pinching little pieces like that. One good thing with curly hair is what you cut is what you see, like it reacts just the way you've cut. You don't expect
anything different.
So it's good to cut the curls progressively without pulling them so that they are not shorter than the length you want. And you can always go back and cut it to the length you want than cutting them shorter, because when you cut them shorter, you can't go back. To maintain this hairstyle, personally, I prefer misting with some water and then follow with an oil spray. Just like natural hair, this hair also needs trimming, at least after about 2 weeks. Whenever you see, you need to make some necessary adjustments to bring it back to shape.